Hello friends, today we are going to study about distance and displacement. Look here. From point P, a ram is moving towards another point which is 12 km far away from this point. And from this point, again, ram is moving to another point that is 5 km away from that point towards west. So, and reaching at a point Q. He had started from point P and now he had reached at point Q. So, what is the distance covered by ram? We know, first he moved 12 km, then 7 km. So, the distance covered by the ram will be 17 km. Now, what will be the displacement? The shortest distance from point P to Q, directly he can move like this, or from this you can see we are getting, so this is the shortest distance from point P to Q, that will be the displacement of that two. So this is the displacement by Pythagoras, we can find out this will from 90, this will be 13 kilometers. So the displacement will be 13 km. Look here, I am giving you one more example. Shyam was here from A point A and moving towards point B and reach here. This is 60 km away. So what will be the distance? At that time distance will be 60 km. And what will be the displacement from here, he has to reach here, so here also in the same direction. So displacement will be also 60 km because the shortest distance from point A will be same as the distance. So both will be same. But from point B, if he is coming back up to 40 km and reach point C. So at that time, what will be the distance covered? Distance will be 60 km plus 40 km, 100 km. But what will be the displacement? We have to see the last point now where he is. From A, he is this much apart. We don't have to come where he had gone and where. Now the shortest distance from the starting point to the ending point will be 60 minus 40. This will be 20 kilometer. So the displacement will be 20 kilometer. So from all this we come to know that displacement can be equal to distance and displacement can be equal, can become equal, displacement can be equal, or distance can be greater than displacement, but displacement cannot be greater than distance. It can be equal also, or distance can be greater than displacement. Now one more example I am giving. From this point S, if ram is moving in a circular path and coming back to the same point, and this is 40 kilometer he moved, so what will be the distance? At that time distance will be 40 kilometers. Then what will be displacement? He had started from S and now he had came back. So his starting point and the ending point are same only. So here the displacement will be 0 kilometer. So from this we come to know that this displacement can be 0 also. If he is moving, means distance is greater than 0, but distance will never come 0 because every time if he started moving from, means he had covered some distance. So distance cannot be 0, but displacement can become 0. So look here we have found. Now we come to know that from these two, which will be a scalar quantity and which will be a vector quantity. Look here, what is a scalar quantity? When any you can say object is having magnitude plus direction. At that time it is vector quantity, but if any object is going with magnitude and without direction, means look here he is going in any of the path without direction, he can go here also, he can go here also, he can go here also. If he start moving like this and reach here, means it has no fixed direction, it can go anywhere. But displacement has a fixed direction with magnitude. So here it is having, displacement is having a fixed direction, so it is called a vector quantity with magnitude also there, and here also magnitude is there but without direction. So distance is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. As what, when we can say it is a vector quantity, when it has magnitude plus direction, and distance magnitude without any direction, fixed direction, that will be. So distance is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you like it, please subscribe to my channel so that I can bring more such videos for you. Thank you so much.